Jesus was crucified, dead, and buried, but when he was on the cross, the chief priests mocked him and said, "If thou be the Christ, come down from the cross and we will believe you." And they mocked him and they spit on him. These are the chief priests. And they conspired weeks and months before how to kill him. And then they came to this divine plan. But yet it was a plan of God that he become a sacrifice for sins. And those who cursed him shall go into everlasting darkness. But when they tempted him, or they called out for him, "If thou be the Son of God, come down from the cross." And they said, "He saved others, himself he cannot save. Let God have him if he will have him." These are the mockers of Christ, who will bear the judgment in the last day of his wrath. Now, believers are all to follow Christ. And Paul writes, "I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, and I live by the faith of the love of Christ, by his blood." And his works, the deeds of the flesh, are crucified through the Spirit. But many have come down from their cross. Jesus said, "If any man follow me, let him take up his cross and follow me." Many have come down from their cross because mockers have called them down and they have subjected themselves to losing their salvation by coming down from their cross. They no longer deny themselves. They no longer deny ungodliness and worldly lust. They no longer live sober and righteous and holy in this world. They have come down from their cross and have lost their salvation. And many have tried to find it, a place for repentance, but there isn't one because God has rejected them. Count the cost before you go on to follow Christ, because if you don't have the wherewithal, if you don't have the Spirit of Christ in you, you are none of his. So don't try to fake it.